I want you to please take out the paper that's inside of your yellow folders. It is something that we're going to do together. So one side is a peer revising sheet, and the other side is a paper that we're going to make a list with. Can everybody take this out? Let me see who's going to be first. I want us to practice finding domain-specific words first, okay?
Domain-specific vocabulary is such an important feature for their writing that Ms. Ramsey makes sure the students get multiple opportunities to practice with it. First, in a whole group setting.
If we were writing instructions on how to fly a plane, what would be some very domain-specific vocabulary words that I would find in this how-to writing? Keyshawn, can you tell me one?
Landing.
Landing, that's excellent. Laquan?
Radar.
Radar, absolutely. I'm sure they have to check their radar screen, right? So these are domain-specific words. Are any of these words in my sunflower procedure writing? No. Because it's different. How many of you feel confident that you can now find domain-specific vocabulary words for your own piece? Raise your hand. Okay, good. So if you look at this paper right here, on your left side, it says make a list of transitional words to use today. And then on the right side, who can read that part for me, please? Nice and loud. Jaquan, go ahead.
Make a list of domain-specific vocabulary words. These are the words that relate to your procedural writing topic specifically.
Write as many as you can. So take the next 3 minutes to go ahead now and write down all the words you can think of in both columns. You may begin.
After working through several examples together, Ms. Ramsey has the students work individually and then in pairs.
Excellent. Okay, now we're gonna move right along. I want you to work with the person sitting next to you. So you may have to travel a bit if somebody else is buddied up already. But I want you to talk to your partner about your domain-specific word. So first of all, Jeffrey, it'll sound like this. If you're gonna talk to Lennon, you have to tell him what your topic is, right? What you're planning to write about, and then you're gonna share your words. London, you'll do the same. After that, you can compare your transitional phrases list to see if there's anything that you left out. That way, tomorrow, when we begin to draft, you'll have this great long list for a resource, okay? So go ahead and turn to your partner now and read and share.
What's your topic?
Mine is how to box
apps. Mine is how to send text messages on Apple iPhone.
My transitional words is next, later, further words, after, done, finish, then, first, thereafter, onwards. And my domain-specific vocabulary is GIMP, other, colors, scissors, designs, keychains, strings, and art.
My transitional words are first, second, third, next, last, and finally. Domain-specific vocabulary words. One of them is cord, the next one is charge, the third one is Apple ID, and the fourth one is iTunes, and the fifth one is syncing.
Oh, I got one keypad. Because when you're trying to text a message, the thing pops up and you get to type.
I'm hearing a lot of really good conversations.
Once the partnering work is done, Ms. Ramsey brings the class back to whole group and gives students a chance to share what they've been working on.
I like that some people are suggesting words for others. Okay, so now here's what I need. I need for someone who's really ready today, someone who's prepared, someone who feels really confident in all they've done so far, and they are ready to come up and share what they wrote yesterday, and I want them to use their words from today. London, you can go first.
Sure.
Are we all ready and giving him good listening ears and everything like that? We're being great audience members, so we're just listening to our peers right now, okay? Go ahead.
This is my introduction of how to plant a tomato. It's in the following, you will learn how to plant a tomato. Tomato lovers, it's fun, easy, and you get dirty, but it's very tiring when it's very hot. Purpose, when you plant a tomato, you're putting something in the ground, then it comes out as food. You can make a very good salad with it, and it's fun. Materials, you will need tomato seeds, good soil, water, and TLC, which is tender loving care. First, you need some tomato seeds. You can even germatize them if you want. Did I say it right?
Nice domain specific word. Keep going.
Next, make a hole in the soil. You can use your index finger, you either use the first or second line on it. Next, put the tomato seeds into the hole. make sure you use the soil and cover the hole back up. Then you have a watering can, and you sprinkle the water over where you plant the seed. Lastly, give that baby some more TLC. Give it confidence after all that hard work. You have your tomatoes.
Very good. Let's give 5 claps for learning real quick. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. Hold on. Before the next person shares, I know you're very eager. Let's just do some peer feedback all as a group. What can we say about London's piece? Something that we enjoyed a lot. I'll tell you what I enjoyed. London had a lot of his own voice in it, didn't he? Right? There was a lot of London. How many of you noticed that? Okay. What did you enjoy specifically, Anthony?
I enjoy when he used the first, next, and last.
So you were able to follow along in sequence because you knew where he was going, right? Okay, are there any grows or any suggestions or recommendations? Were you able to follow along with these steps and really get a complete understanding, or where do you think he might need to add on tomorrow? Joshua?
You could follow along, but he should add some more.
To which part?
To the steps, like some more details and clues.
Was there one step in particular that was kind of unclear?
I don't remember.
Okay. You remember, Jeff? This is all loving criticism. Go ahead.
When you said put some more TLC in there, he should have combined that with another step because
I agree. Something more specific. So how can I give a plant TLC other than just loving it like a plant, right? So does that mean giving it more fertilizer, more sunlight, more water? And one thing that I noticed, and London, you have this great outline. You're so ready to go. You're definitely on the way, and I really enjoy listening to that. But I think that because you're such an expert, you're having to go back now and read it as a novice, okay?
As Ms. Ramsey indicates, the students will continue to revise their pieces by adding clarification, expanding their vocabulary use, and researching further into the topics.
Everything is complete. All right, I really want to celebrate what we did today. Everyone stand up and give yourself a round of applause for a good lesson. Just a round of applause. All right.